Scientists at the Theoretical Physics Department of the University of Innsbruck have proposed an experimental setup that should help to better understand the formation of quasicrystals. Quasicrystals have been known since the 1980s, but many of their properties are not yet fully understood by scientists. Properties of quasicrystals and their mechanisms that lead to their formation are complex. It is difficult to study them by numerical means using computers.
But they could be simulated in an experiment with cold atoms and corresponding laser fields to gain new insights. And the exciting thing is that if you set it up and investigate it, you can find new properties of such a quasicrystal that could provide important impetus for materials research in the future. It is really not known how this material will behave in a real-world setup.
Quantum optics can help to investigate this. In the so far theoretically proposed experiment, the atoms have to be cooled down to temperatures close to absolute zero so that quantum physical properties become apparent.
Usually, self-ordering creates a structure which repeats periodically, as we are used to in crystals and solids. We've tried a trick here and imposed a geometry with 8 different directions on the light. As we know from mathematics, such a structure in which 8 equivalent different directions occur cannot result in a periodic pattern. So now the particles and the light have to find a compromise between the rotation symmetry of the light and the idea to arrange themselves periodically and spatially regular.
Symmetry is an essential property of crystals. As in salt crystals, for example, the atoms are arranged periodically in all 3 directions in space. This is different in quasicrystals. Here too, the atoms are ordered, but not 3-dimensionally periodic, rather in a special rotational way. Special symmetries are possible in them, such as an 8-fold rotation. This is not only of scientific interest. For centuries, forms such as can be found in quasicrystals have also been found in the art of various peoples.
In simple language, quasicrystals are materials which are ordered rotationally, not translationally like common crystals. If you rotate some object with 45 degrees, then if it is invariant, you cannot distinguish from the initial state, it is called that it has an 8-fold rotational symmetry. In this case, this 8-fold rotational symmetry is the symmetry of the emergent states, basically. So, but in this 8-fold rotational symmetry is very special because it is forbidden in all natural crystals like a diamond crystal or snowflakes.
As a result of the specially proposed experimental setup with 8 mirrors and circular polarized light, the researchers can provoke a very rare effect in the entirely quantum mechanical system. This is called emergent symmetry. To explain it, a kind of reference point is needed. This is the Hamiltonian of the system. It is a mathematical tool to describe a system quantum mechanically. Normally, the arrangement of atoms in the ground state is less symmetric than the Hamilton function, but with emergent symmetry, it is more symmetric than the Hamiltonian.
Under the special condition, in our proposal, a quasicrystal potential with the 8-fold rotational symmetry emerges in the low energy physics. So again, this is an emergent symmetry in our proposal because the Hamiltonian of the system doesn't have this 8-fold rotational symmetry, but it is just this low energy state which have this. And as a consequence, then atoms start to self-order in this emergent quasicrystalline potential in a very special way, and they exhibit basically it is called the quasicrystalline order.
The goal of the theoretical physicists was also to develop an experiment that could be carried out with today's means for their colleagues from the practical field. Although the setup is complex, the proposed methods and necessary technical components are already being used in the laboratory.
if you have a natural quasicrystal, it is really difficult to modify this quasicrystal and see what happens. But in our system, it is everything, it is tunable. So you can tune many parameters and examine what happens to the quasicrystal. We basically simulate a natural quasicrystal with the artificial setup. Quasicrystals have a very interesting property. For instance, three-dimensional quasicrystal can be imagined as a projection of a fictitious four-dimensional crystal into a three-dimension. So then by studying a three-dimensional quasicrystal, you can basically understand how a fictitious four-dimensional crystal could work in principle.
The experiment should work for all polarizable atoms that can be cooled down to the ground state and thus show their quantum mechanical state. Whether quasicrystals contain properties such as new forms of superconductivity could be shown if the proposed setup is put into practice.